Hello everyone, I'm now at Changsha Pedestrian Street, Hunan Province. Changsha is a well-known vacation destination, and usually this street is full to burst with visitors. But today you can see there are not so many people here, and almost everyone is wearing a mask.
These days we are not busy like before because of the COVID-19 epidemic. Although Changsha residents like to go out and play, all of them are very proactive in cooperation with the government to contain the outbreak at this time. We have taken a series of precautions to prevent the epidemic. We arrange disinfection and sterilization work regularly. Before entering the store, customers need to show their health and travel code, wear mask, and maintain a safe distance during the purchase process. We will also disinfect customers' hands with medical alcohol.
Here is one of the many vaccination stations in Changsha City. You can see there are a lot of citizens here waiting to get vaccinated.
我今天是来打第二针的，第一针打了之后呢，没有什么不良反应。看到这里很有秩序，也没等太长的时间。到目前为止的话，我们中心累计接种了87000多剂次的新冠疫苗，累计覆盖了将近55000多人次。最近几天以来，市民的打疫苗积极性也更高了，所以我们也开通了网上预约。 在现场的话，也开通了59岁以上老年人的优先接种通道，以及召唤了一些志愿者在这里更好的服务市民。
The Tianjin District has special testing stations. On July 31st, 130 volunteer teams, including 3,000 volunteers, were organized in just 20 hours.
I'm a student from Hunan Agricultural University. As the saying goes that when difficulties arise in one place, aid comes from everywhere. I hope that I can also contribute my strength to fight the 90 COVID disease.
According to Hunan Department of Commerce, the province has sufficient reserves of daily necessities, such as rice, flour, oil, meat, eggs, milk, and vegetables, and medical and epidemic prevention materials, such as masks and disinfectant. The province has many famous scenic spots, and responding quickly to the Delta variant was very important. The medical teams are working to identify key personnel and increase the intensity of medical treatment. Zhangjiajie, home to the Everest Mountains, is one of China's most famous tourist destinations. It's also home to a population of 1.51 million. Last year, due to the epidemic, the city tourism revenue fell by 31.5% year-on-year, and local fiscal revenue dropped by 14.8%. Even so, the added value of the tertiary industry in Zhangjiajie still accounted for 69.57% of GDP. Due to the resurgence of COVID, Zhangjiajie shut all scenic spots, theaters, cinemas, KTV, and other gathering places. Any travelers affected will be refunded. A total of 754 groups and 119,900 travelers who had been stranded in Zhangjiajie were accommodated, and 24-hour services were provided. Dozens of experts have been sent by the provincial government to aid investigation, in addition to doctors specializing in traditional Chinese and Western medicine to guide prevention and control and treatment in Zhuzhou City. Other popular holiday destinations in Xiangxi, Tujia, and Miao Autonomous Prefecture, including the ancient city of Fenghuang, Furongtang, and Shibadong Village, stopped receiving travelers from Wednesday.
From July 20 to August 2nd, Hunan Province reported 28 confirmed COVID-19 cases, including 3 imported cases. 28 people were hospitalized. No deaths related to COVID-19 were reported. No one should stand by and watch prevention and control of the virus. I believe with concerted efforts, we are able to overcome the epidemic.